Welcome to the Everything Sparkle Show. It is our 65th episode, and what better way to start it with 120 Army. How are you today?
Good, thank you. Nice to meet you.
So explain what 120 Army is.
So the heart of 120 Army is really just putting aside denominational differences, theological differences, just to be simple and be united in prayer. It's the one common unifier of all religion. And that's really people who aren't even believers at times of stress can be heard, you know, praying or uttering a prayer or something like that. So we try to really just be simple and keep it to as simple as possible. So the idea is that every day at 1:20 p.m. an alarm goes off. We have an app that actually produces a single prayer focus time zone by time zone across the U.S. and the world. And so it's just a way of unifying people in heart and in mind and in purpose, rather than allowing ourselves to really kind of butt heads over the remedial things.
So when did you guys start this? How long ago?
So it's actually an idea that's been around for about 8 years, but I got involved about 5 years ago, and what it currently is has really kind of since then transpired into what it is. You know, I always call it the unministry ministry. I work on a cattle ranch outside of this, so I never expected to be doing anything like this at all.
So you say army, is that just a term because we're God's army, or did you actually, is the military involved in this?
No, so I don't, I'm not a veteran, I didn't serve in the military or anything like that. It's actually kind of more so because of the definitional aspect of an army as a group or a mass of people moving in concert for a specific purpose. And the idea is just is unity. When we come together, we put our hearts and minds to something, as individuals even, we can accomplish great things. But what happens when more people begin to do that? And so it's really giving people something to be involved in that's productive for their lives rather than kind of rigorous and demeaning, you might want to say. So.
And everybody prays at 1:20.
Yes. Yeah. It kind of, you know, I'm kind of a believer myself personally. You know, you can claim a lot of things. You can bark loud in your kennel is what I always say, in your safe spot, you know. And people like to talk big in their churches or in their private area. But when you're out in the middle of the day, an alarm goes off, how much courage do you have to live for what you really believe in? And I'm a firm believer in prayer, and that, you know, God hears prayers just from experience. So it challenges people to kind of live brave as well as share it with other people.
Beautiful. So tell me some of what you've seen come out of that since you guys have been around.
Oh, gosh. Well, you know, some of the stories we have is, you know, people call who aren't even, they're not Christian, they're not believers or anything, you know. One lady is a friend of my wife's, they're Rastafarian couple, just doing their thing. One day they called us up and said, hey, my husband's in the hospital. He's in a medically induced coma. They didn't know what happened. They started asking for prayer. We began praying, and more of us kind of got together praying for him. And all of a sudden, after about 3 days, he just sat up out of a medically induced coma, pulled all the tubes out and said enough. And everybody was like shocked out of their minds. So stories like that are not uncommon, to be honest with you.
Wow. So how many people do you think are a part of this? Can you even track that? How many people?
Yeah. So actually we have about 8,000 people in 6 different nations that are actually making use of our app. Our app is actually fairly new. We had to have it custom built because no developers had anything that would time zone by time zone notify people. It was just kind of one mass thing. So it really creates a wave of prayer and hope that crosses our nation. Kind of, I always say it kind of baptizes the nation for real.
So we just go to 120 Army on our app store?
Yeah, 120 Army.
Okay,
yeah.
That's what we're going to do. Everybody has got to go into their app store and do that.
Please do.
This is going to be... And my after, after when it comes to apps, I'm like an old lady.
I tell most people are, you know, maybe over the top, but I'm kind of computarded in the definitional term. I'm slow when it comes to computers and stuff.
Well, and I bet a lot of people had to do this for their parents and stuff, right? Get the app on there.
Yeah, I've helped 89-year-old old war vets actually sign up on it.
So that's it, right?
That is it. Yes, it is.
So yes, it's very simple. Just the 120 Army app. I love this. This is so exciting.
That's, it's cool because it actually allows people to interact semi kind of like an Instagram or something. You can post prayers on a wall. People can pray along with you. You get notified when they're praying, when they comment. So it's something that really is meant to unify hearts and minds, rather than unify a congregation or a group or a culture of, you know, specific thing. And that's how most churches work, not to undercut anything.
Well, I love that right now, because right now, no, we're not even going to church. So this is really exciting. This is such a great time for people to really start this, because I think we're all searching for some unity right now in our lives.
Yes. Yeah, we've actually, for the last 5 years, we've been making videos every Sunday, and then kind of the midweek, we call it a midweek mindset or a Sunday sit down. And we just share encouraging thoughts or things that would challenge what, you know, your comfort zone in your faith would be. You know, a lot of times it's easy to pray like, oh, you know, God fix this, God do that, when sometimes where's your perseverance or where's your patience or your trust? You know, really it challenges you to believe or think deeper about what you believe in your faith. So I've done 30 years of martial arts. So, you know, really kind of challenging myself and my thought processes at times is really what I call it glitch hunting. I search for the glitches within myself and I try to hunt them down and whittle at them, you know, to make it a strength.
So you told us some good stories of some things you've seen. Have you seen any like famous people or maybe just that you didn't even know was part of the 120 and then they're like, yeah, we do this every day. Is there anybody that you're surprised was part of this?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know about anybody famous. I'm kind of an uncultured swine myself, I usually say.
Because you're out on the farm.
Yeah, I just throw hay and shovel stuff. But, you know, there's actually city leaders. Actually, there's a lot of pastors and stuff that have gotten involved.
That's good. Our city leaders should be in this. I love that. That's very impressive.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of Jerry Dyer, actually, personally.
He's been here. We love Jerry, too.
He's an amazing guy, really. So people like that, you know, have slowly come on board and gotten a hold of it. Like I said, our app has 500 users at this point, and we've done no marketing. Even the thousands of people who've come to it, we've never marketed. We've never done anything like that. We just grassroots, guerrilla style is the way I say it.
That's the way to do it. It really is. Is there ever a conference? Are you guys looking in the future maybe to have a team building event yearly? Has that ever come up? Or
You know, I'm a really bad businessman and salesman.
I need to join forces with you.
Yeah, I just, you know, that's kind of why we do the grassroots guerrilla thing, just because I've always been really simple. Even the dojo, the martial arts school that I run is actually out in the dunes in Oceano. I live on the coast part-time, and I live here in Tower District part-time doing this. And I believe in it. And so my wife and my family and I, we've contributed financially to this for quite a while until we became a 501c. So this is really kind of surreal to me.
That is such a great story. Wow. And I love it because it reminds people to pray. I think whether you're a Christian or not, sometimes we just forget or we get busy, especially before we started slowing down. Now everybody was just, so I was like, I forgot today to just be thankful.
It's a wonderful thing, but again, it invites people to interact with each other, you know what I mean? Whether you're Christian or Muslim or Jewish, and I've had friends from all different aspects and denominations, they'll pray for you, they'll accept a prayer.
And I love that. I really like that you're cutting down those barriers, because I think a lot of people are always feel apprehensive because of whatever religion they are in or where they were raised. So I love that.
Most religious conversations turn into a sparring match, it seems like, and we try to completely skirt around that. And just,
because it's just prayer. It really has nothing to do about what you...
Can't argue with that.
As long as you believe in God, that's all you need to believe in,
that's
right?
It, yeah. Just, you know, really just reach out. And for those who don't, I have friends who are more eclectic, Buddhist, other things, and they love it because it gives them a chance to recenter, they would say, and really invite positivity into their day or put up a positive thought. So I just say, hey, just start there. Start wherever you're at.
I mean, right, because there's no negatives about this.
No. And I mean, from science to religion itself, you know, the human mind, when we put our mind to something and we really express belief and walk out faith, the most amazing things can happen. You know, a lot of people who are successful, a lot of people who've accomplished things, it really just started with faith, a hope, a dream, a thought. And when you put something behind that, like an app or like more people coming together, it brings a greater reality into our lives of what we're hoping for. And that's, to be honest, unity, you know, especially in times when things are so divided. And now we're all kind of stuck in our homes and people are kind of gnawing on their own feet, so to speak. You know, it gives you something to continue to keep positive, I guess, thoughts and feelings flowing.
Who came up with the time, the 120? Why so specific?
So actually, I'll give credit to my bro, Dino Genito, actually. It was just a couple of guys who were just, hey, you know, we want a little bit more of God in our lives. So they just started getting together. And one day, some guy called up and said, hey, I'm a part of your 120 army. And it was like, there you go.
I love it.
But it's based on Psalms 120, verse 1. I cried out to the Lord in my distress, and he answered me. And because of the way I grew up, I always tell everybody, you know, what's more distressing than living in luxury? Because you forget what real perseverance is, what real strength is, and how it comes. It really manifests out of us is when we're challenged. So that's kind of one of my personal beliefs.
I love that. Okay, we got to watch the video. I love the music to it and everything, the video that you sent.
Oh, sure. Thank you.
Thank you so much for sharing that, and thank you so much for coming on the show. Is there anything you'd like to say to our viewers before you go?
Gosh, you know, the 120, it's a message, a movement of life. When a message is really alive in your heart, you're going to walk it out with movement, and when that movement occurs, you reap the life that you're really seeking. And until then, it's just empty wishes and hopes. So, you know, put something behind what you're really thinking and feeling, and you'll see it happen, and hopefully 120 Army can be a part of that.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you. Appreciate it.
What if it breaks? What if it shines?